Right about now, we are joined the executive mayor, Mzwandile Masina, to tell us more about what's happening today.
So, Baba Slanganengani, you know, the conversations we're having here is the fact that what activities is the youth taking this month? And then we got invited, like someone, okay, umasipala sekurhuleni une plan. That's why it's a full house. La mangivulumnyawo ngibonile, it's a full house. Youth attendile, and it's an economic summit. And our argument was that every generation has got its own story and its own struggle. The 76 one, the 80s one, you know, there was fire in the 80s.
Yes.
The 90s one almost got into a civil war. We got out, we talked into Zalunga up to manje, and here's an economic summit. What inspires these things? Because I think also as abantu abadala manje, we need to listen to what these young guys, their definition of June 16.
No, it's a very important gathering of young people, especially the leadership, who represent massive young people who are in different communities within the city of Ekurhuleni.
Yeah.
They've gathered here basically to look at issues that affect them, in particular the issues of economic opportunities in the main. But because the issue of youth development is a whole spectrum, there's a range of discussions here, from policy to programs that must be implemented to in order to support young people. We've made some pronouncement which in our view will take youth development to another level in the city.
Yeah.
But as government alone, we are not going to be doing sufficiently if we don't have private sector actively participating.
Yes.
So we have a number of companies here that are here to hear for themselves the plight of young people, and also to begin to hear suggestions that are going to help us to deal with issues of youth unemployment, the issues of teen pregnancy,
and all those things.
So we're really happy that young leaders have gathered actually to come up, and from here they will emerge with an action plan which is going to be institutionalized in government, and we're going to look for budget so that we can support initiative coming from young people.
I know Maukuluma Ekurhuleni ukuthi ngisashuthi Zola 7. I used to exploit them hure, because I know with Mangufie Ekurhuleni, I only have to find a certain signature and they will give me what I want, and then I get the budget. I'm putting somebody's score in the part.
Yeah.
I can vouch that Ekurhuleni is one of the most aggressive municipalities in the country.
Yes, it's very, very important.
Yeah.
One of the things that we mentioned, we have taken a posture that we must prioritize education in all our efforts.
Yes.
Where we are now, there used to be about 10 million rand budget worth of bursaries.
Mm-hmm.
We've increased that to about 100 million as we speak.
Wow.
Almost 1,780 kids are at different universities in the city. Because we want to bring about change and development.
Yeah.
Because our take is that it's not just about economic development, but it's about also personal development.
Yes.
If you are to break the cycle of poverty, it can't be that you are born in 1997, you don't have formal tertiary qualification, you had no struggle to fight, you were born way after democracy. So it's important that we consolidate and make sure that these young people can be ready for employment opportunities, but also they can create small businesses that can also create employment opportunities for others who might be less fortunate. So we are moving in there aggressively, ensuring that no young person is left out. So this free education that we are talking about, even at a national level, young people must understand that it is compulsory. Every young person must go there.
Yeah.
So it's not a matter of choice whether you can or you cannot go. We want all young people to go to institutions of higher learning so that we can change the face of the city.
Is it reserved only for the youth of Ekurhuleni? Because end of the day, Gune OR Airport, which is geographically migrant. So the other young people who are...
Well, we have limited resources. We can only think about our citizens. We need to develop our citizens. You know, we have a lot of problems like those, especially in human settlement. You give Zola 7 a house, then his uncle from Limpopo or from KZN or Eastern Cape to say, hey, malume, he's angapa, kune zindlu za mahala. So we want to really prioritize our people. When we talk human settlement, those people who have been staying in their backyard as dwellers in the backyards must be prioritized. People in the informal settlements must be prioritized. So even with regard to education, we are much more focused in ensuring that at least young people from Ekurhuleni are the first beneficiaries of the work that we are doing.